I'm Kimberly from 37 Signals, the makers of Basecamp. In this video, I'm going to walk you through 10 things you can do in Basecamp you might not know about. I made a similar video to this a couple of years ago, but since we're always making improvements, I thought it was time for another one. So let's go. There are a couple ways you can customize your home screen, either to organize it or just to make it pretty. Of course, there's pinning a project to the top, but you can also add color. Just mouse over the color wheel and select a color for the project. This can be helpful when you want to quickly identify projects. Maybe you make all your client projects yellow, or you make your most important projects green. The choice is yours. When you want to group similar projects together on your home screen, you can create a stack. Just drag and drop one project on top of another and give your stack a name. You can also add an image to the stack or give your stack a color. Your Basecamp home screen is personal to you. That means if you create stacks of projects or give a project a color, you're the only one who can see it. It doesn't affect how the home screens look for anyone else on your Basecamp account. At the bottom of your home screen, you'll see your assignments. This shows a list of items that have been assigned to you across all your projects. If that view feels like a lot, you can trim it down by setting priorities. Click See All to go to your My Assignments page. You can also find that page under My Stuff. You'll see a section called Up Next where you can prioritize tasks. To add something to Up Next, just mouse over it, then click the up arrow. When you return to your homepage, your assignments show only what's up next, but the full list is just a click away. Sometimes you get a notification in your Hey menu that you're not quite ready to deal with, but you want to make sure it doesn't slip through the cracks. When that's the case, use Don't Forget. From the three-dot menu, select Don't Forget to add it to a separate section in your Hey menu. You can also add something to Don't Forget that you've already seen. Just mouse over the item and click the Don't Forget icon. Another option for managing notifications is to mark something unseen, just like you might do to an email. From the Hey menu, head to your previous notifications, click the three-dot menu, and then mark as unread. That floats the notification back to the top of your Hey menu. You probably know that if you want to make sure someone sees something in Basecamp, you can at mention them. That highlights the notification in their Hey menu. But if you find yourself tagging multiple people over and over again, or adding the same group of people to new projects, you can simplify your process by creating a group. If you're an account owner or admin, head to Admin Land, then go to Manage Groups. Click Make a New Group and give your group a name. Start typing the names of who should be in your group, then click Add This Group. Now, when you need to include everyone in the group, just at mention the group's name and everyone is automatically included. If you use pings to communicate with multiple people at the same time, it can sometimes be hard to keep track of the different threads. You might have a group talking about a project and another group talking about their latest beach read. And when some of the same people are in each ping conversation, it can be hard to quickly tell them apart. To make that easier, you can rename your pings. With the ping open, click on the names at the top and give the ping a name. You can also add an image. Now there's no mistaking one ping conversation for another. When you do the same type of work over and over again, you can save a lot of time by creating a project template. But sometimes you might start a project not realizing you want to repeat that work later. When that happens, you can spin up a template from an existing project. From the project page, click the three-dot menu and go to Save as a Project Template. Give your template a name and decide if your template will include the same people that are on the current project. You can also choose if you'd like any comments, like things that have been added to to-dos or docs and files, to appear in your new template. Create the template, and when you need to make a new project from the template, you can get it set up with just a few clicks. The schedule tool within a Basecamp project shows events and assignments with due dates, but you can adjust that. Click the three-dot menu and go to Choose What to Show. When you select Events Only, those dated to-dos won't show up on the calendar. And for my Basecamp pros, you can add a second schedule tool if you want events and assignments to show, but in separate schedules. From the project page, use the three-dot menu and go to Setup Tools, where you can add another schedule and then specify what you want to show on each calendar. When you have a lot of deadlines across a lot of projects, it's even more important to stay on top of it all. One report that can really help is Overdue To-dos. Under Activity, click Choose a Report, then Overdue To-dos. This page compiles the to-dos across all your projects with deadlines that have passed, regardless if they're assigned to you or to someone else. We love Hill Charts at 37 Signals as they're a great way to visually track how your to-dos are doing from the figuring it out stage to making it happen. When you have a lot of Hill Charts across a lot of projects, there's an easy way to see them all at the same time. From Activity, click Choose a Report, then Hilltop View. Clicking a Hill Chart from here will take you straight to that project. I hope I showed you something you didn't already know about. Let me know in the comments below if I taught you something new. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, please reach out to our support team at support@basecamp.com.